Okay, we're good to start. So it's my very great pleasure to introduce Jo Lindley. And Jo is a picture books author and illustrator. She's the creator of Hello Summer, which is the book you're going to hear about, and several other books that I'm sure she will tell you about and that you are welcome to ask about. So that is enough from me, and over to Jo.
Hello, thanks, Emily. So it's really good to be here with everybody, and I'm looking forward to telling you all about Hello Summer. First of all, though, I'm really sorry. That first photo of me shows me with pink hair. It all grew out. I'm really sorry, but there's a little bit of purple, so still a little bit of fun there, hopefully. And so I'm going to tell you about Hello Summer. So here's the book, Hello Summer. And I don't think it could be more summery right now. It is great out there, isn't it? So hopefully this is going to fit right in with the season that we're currently enjoying. But first of all, let me show you the back page. Okay, so the back page here, we have Hello Spring, Hello Summer, Hello Autumn, and Hello Winter. So these four are best friends. And they're each named after a different season. And this book is obviously all about Hello Summer. And with his friends, he enjoys his season. So I'm going to share the screen and show you the book. So here we go. Hopefully that is all clear with everybody. So, I've not started from the beginning. Here we go. Giveaway. Midway point. Okay, so this is where they live. They live in a place called Season Isle, and it's a magical kingdom, and it's where they have all their fun and games. It's also where they experience some big feelings. So, spring, summer, autumn, and winter were best friends. They played together all year round, taking it in turns to wear the weather crown and lead the games. Now the weather crown, wonder if you can see where the weather crown is at the moment. So here's winter's on the left, then we've got autumn, then the summer, and then the spring. And spring has a crown on her head, and that is the weather crown. Spring's games were full of joy and colour. As the best friends weaved amongst the bright yellow flowers, they realised something special. The sunflowers are almost as tall as us, exclaimed autumn. And you know what that means, said spring. It's summertime, answered Summer. Very, very excited. The little seasons gathered excitedly under the TikTok tree, and Spring passed the weather crown to Summer. His friends couldn't wait to play his sunny games. Whenever Summer wore the crown, the sun rose high in the sky, and the days were long, perfect for... A trip to the beach, suggested Summer. His friends could have burst. Yippee, they cried. Oops, I can't see. Okay, they filled a little wagon with summer supplies and off they went with the sun warming the way. Here we can see we've got a beach ball. We've got a spade and a bucket. We've got a picnic blanket and almost definitely a picnic in the basket. In the shade of Shadow Valley, they took a break from their journey. Let's play catch, said Summer, rummaging in the wagon for his ball. With a boing, Summer bounced the ball to Spring. Spring rolled it to Autumn, who passed it to Winter. Ready, Winter called to Summer, launching the ball into the air. But a gust of wind carried it higher and faster than Winter had planned. It looped over Summer's head and... Pop! It burst on a spiky branch. Summer gasped. I'm sorry, Winter apologized. It was an accident. Summer swallowed his frustration. It's okay. Come on, let's keep going. As they approached Wiggly River, Autumn's tummy growled very loudly. Now, I wonder if everybody at school can help me with this sound. See that when your stomach is growling, it goes grrr. Can everyone go grrr? Whoa, that's a big grumbly tummy, isn't it? Sounds like it's picnic o'clock, giggled Summer. The thought of a delicious meal had cheered him up. Together, they laid the blanket out on the grass, followed by a yummy array of sandwiches, fruit, cupcakes, and jelly. But as the friends were taking their first bite, a hungry ant joined them, followed by a stampede of greedy guzzlers. Stop, cried Summer. That's my sandwich. Oh no, can we see the squirrel has taken Summer's sandwich? Soon there were nothing but crumbs left behind. It's kind to share, smiled Spring. Grrr, grumbled Autumn's tummy. With the sun beating down on them, Summer could feel his temperature rising. Nothing was going to plan. Spring could see he was getting upset. Try counting to three, she said gently. It might help you feel calmer. I am calm, snapped Summer, clenching his fists. Let's keep going. They weren't far from the beach now. Crossing the river with a hop, skip and a jump, the friends arrived on Sandy Side. Let's build a great big sandcastle, suggested Winter. Hurrah, cried Summer. In his excitement, he'd forgotten the rest of the day's bad luck. Together, they scooped and sculpted the sand into a fabulous fortress. This is the best sandcastle ever, declared Summer as he stepped back to admire his masterpiece. All it needs now is some water for the moat. Can we see the moat around the sandcastle? I wonder how they're going to fill that in. Let's see. Just then, a wave tumbled onto the beach and the moat began to fill with water. Wow, gasped Spring. Majestic, said Autumn. Can see the crab is enjoying it too, isn't he? Maybe it's going to be his little home. But the water kept coming and coming. The sandcastle was beginning to crumble. It's too much, shouted Summer. Stop, stop, stop. But it was no use. As the wave retreated, the magnificent sandcastle toppled into a pitiful pile. No, it's not fair, wailed Summer, and he chased the mischievous wave. But the wave did what waves do. It turned around and chased him back. It crashed at his feet, splashing him from head to toe. Winter gasped. Autumn stifled a giggle. Well, that was that. Leave me alone. Summer was. Can everyone say what Summer was? He was angry. Like a raging tornado, Summer trampled the remains of the sandcastle. His face felt as hot as the sun. His heart pounded in his chest, and his thoughts were jumbled in his head. But as the tears rolled down his cheeks, he remembered Spring's advice. Count to three. It was worth a try. One, his heartbeat calmed. Two, his thoughts settled. Three, his face cooled. Summer wiped away his tears. He didn't feel so angry anymore. He shuffled over to his friends. I'm sorry I shouted at you, he said. Spring smiled. It's okay, she said. You've had a really tough day. I know how that feels. I feel angry sometimes too, said Winter. So do I, agreed Autumn. Want a hug? Summer knew how lucky he was to have such special friends. And with them by his side, he was ready to try again. Wow, he's made it look a lot better this time, hasn't he? He's obviously in a much better mood. So that is the story. So I'm going to stop sharing and tell you a little bit more about the book. Okay, so I wonder if we can talk about a little bit about big feelings. So in this book, Summer has a really big feeling. Can anybody, if they could get their teachers to write it into the chat, what his big feeling was. we got any big feeling suggestions? Anger. Gosh, seeing it written out so many times makes that feeling get even bigger, doesn't it? Anger, angry. Here we go. He was emotional, wasn't he? And furious. Exactly that. So let's see this page again. Look how angry he was. I'm sure we've all felt that way. And it's okay to feel angry, especially when you've had such a bad day. If we look back at his day, first of all, his ball popped. Then his picnic was ruined. Then his sandcastle got washed away. Think everybody would feel angry by that point. But at the same time, he needed to maybe control his feelings a little more, didn't he? And you know how he did that? He counted. Now, I know three, maybe not enough, really. Maybe you want to count to 10, or if you're really angry, 50 or 100. But it really helped him. So I wonder if we can talk a little bit as well about how his friends helped him. So at first, they weren't overly helpful. They were just trying to take his mind off it, which can like improve things a bit. But it wasn't until the end, when he was saying sorry, that they said, yeah, we know how you feel. It's not a good feeling, is it? They were using a special superpower called empathy. Now, this is quite a big word, and it's quite a special word. And I'm not very good at explaining it, but I know that there is some people on YouTube that might help me explain it. So I'm going to share a video, but I'm also going to need the teacher's help, because I have to admit, I find this video quite funny. So at the end, if the teachers could help get everyone settled and ready to move on to the next stage, that would be great. So I'm going to share that video with you now so we can learn a little bit about empathy and how it helps people when they're having some big feelings. Okay. Let's go full screen.
Hello, I'm Mark.
And I'm Murray.
And we're here to tell you about the word empathy.
Empathy, yes, empathy.
Tell them about the word empathy. What's wrong?
You're not gonna believe this, Mark.
What?
But I can't remember what empathy means.
No, that's okay. I'll tell them what empathy means.
Oh, boy! This is so exciting! Mark Ruffalo is gonna tell us about empathy! Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy!
Can I do it?
Go, please, go for it, Mark.
All right. Empathy is when you're able to understand and care about how someone else is feeling.
Oh, right. That's what empathy is.
Yes.
I don't get it.
What?
Sorry.
Okay. Let me see if I can explain it to you in some way.
Okay, I'm going to listen.
Let's say I'm walking along and... Oh!
What?
I stubbed my toe. Oh, that hurts.
Oh, you poor thing,
Murray.
Mark. Oh,
Murray.
That hurts. I can imagine exactly how you feel.
That's
What's it?
That's it. That's empathy.
What's empathy?
You could imagine exactly how I feel. You could understand just how it felt. That's empathy.
I still don't get it.
What?
I still don't get it.
Okay. Let's think of another way.
Okay, let's think of another way. Thinking.
Oh, Murray.
What?
Did I tell you about that time when I lost my favorite teddy bear?
Oh, no.
It was...
This is very sad. Did you love that teddy bear?
I loved that teddy bear.
Oh, I can imagine exactly how you feel. It's really sad feeling. It makes me want to cry like this.
It was sad. It was so sad. But you know what?
What?
You know what empathy is.
I do?
That was empathy.
What?
You could understand how I was feeling, exactly how I was feeling, and understood it. That's empathy.
I get it now. Yes! Yes, I get it!
Yes!
I understand empathy!
You understand empathy, Murray.
I'm so happy right now!
I'm happy, too.
It makes me want to dance the dance of happiness!
I can imagine exactly how you feel. What? I want to dance the dance of happiness, too!
Then what are we waiting for?
Let's do it! Empathy!
Okay.
me. Also,
this next video's moved on. Wait a second. Let's stop that. Okay, great. Hi, everyone. I hope you enjoyed that video. It's one of my favorites, but it does also really, really clearly explain what empathy is. So it helps you understand how other people are feeling. You can feel their emotions. You sometimes might feel that when you see someone cry or when you see someone laugh. When you see someone cry, you might feel sad yourself. When you see someone else laugh, you might feel happy. That's empathy. So, right, I thought we might do a bit of a drawing too. So I thought I might draw Summer, but I might need your help of some of the parts of him. So let's see if I can turn the screen a little bit. Hopefully everyone can see that okay. And I'm gonna start with this part of his face. I'm gonna mainly draw his face. So it's like a big U. So there we've got a big U. And then I like to draw his hair, and his hair kind of sweeps up. See here, it's all swooshy. Let's draw some swooshy hair on him. There we go. And now about his ears. Can anyone tell me what's special about his ears? If you could put it into the chat. Put it up on here just to help you. Let me see what's special about his ears. Pointy, elf-like. Yes, they're elf ears. They are elf ears. He's like a fairy, exactly. Because, you know, not everybody that can just put on a crown and control the weather. He has to be a little bit magic. And his ears show us that he's a fairy or an elf. Draw a pair of pointy ears. Okay. Then in the middle of the face, he's got a nose, just like, right. There we go. His nose is kind of like a C, isn't it? So we just do a bit of a C that's maybe toppled over a little bit. Okay, now this is where I really need your help. So we need to work out what big feeling we're going to do. So we're going to do a few of these just so we can go through some different feelings. So maybe if we could get some suggestions of big feelings. I'm going to draw his circles for eyes and we'll be ready for a big feeling. Do we have any ideas for a big feeling? Surprise, that's a great one. Okay, so I think surprise, we need, how we show how we feel on our face, we use our mouth and we use our eyes and we also use our eyebrows. So surprised, the eyebrows go quite high, don't they? Let's bring his eyebrows all the way up here. Very surprised eyebrows up here. And his dots in his eyes, right in the middle. And then I think we're going to do happy surprised. How about that? Let's try happy surprise. So big mouth. You can see the tongue in here. And let's shave that bit in. Here we go. So he's looking really surprised. Give him his tongue. How about his rosy cheeks? And he's missing something on the top of his head. Any ideas what he might be missing? It needs this color. It's yellow. What are we missing? Oh, the crown. Great. Yes, we're missing the crown. So let's pop his crown on. There we go. And we have drawn Summer. So it's giving him a little bit of a neck. So he's not just a floating head. There we go. He looks a bit more comfortable now, doesn't he? The crown. Yes, we've got some suggestions now. Right. That's surprise. Shall we see if we can do a couple more big feelings? Has anybody got another suggestion of a big feeling? Angry. Oh, frustrated. Okay, we've got some good ones. So let's try angry first. I'm going to try and do four on this page. So let's do the U, the pointy ears, the swooshy hair. Can you still see it that small?
Yeah, hopefully.
His eyes. Now, when you're angry, your eyebrows come all the way down and they look cross. He's looking pretty angry already. So his mouth will be like that. Oh, that's an angry looking summer. How about anxious? Anxious and frustrated. They might be quite similar looking. Let's see, anxious. I think what we'll do is we'll do the U. Oh, I need to draw these bigger. I can't do this small on that size pen. Let's just go back to doing them big. Okay. Sweepy hair. Pointy ears. And then anxious. Anxious is a great word. It's a lot like worried. So let's see if we can make him looking worried. I think maybe if he's looking to the side, thinking who's there, his eyebrows might be pointing upwards now. Put his mouth down there, give him his nose. Oh, he's looking pretty anxious there, isn't he? Do we have any other big feelings? Oh, excited. Okay. How do I show excited different to surprised? That's tricky. You're challenging me now. Let's see. Okay. So let's do excited. Swishy hair. He's so excited. He's squeezing his eyes shut. Can't wait. He also looks like maybe he's laughing a lot there, actually, doesn't he? Oh, that's a tricky one. I think I might make a couple of suggestions. So we see if we can do some other feelings. How about calm? Yeah, a bit like see in Hello Spring. Show you. At the end, when she's a lot calmer than she was during the story. Here we go. She's looking pretty calm there, isn't she? So let's try doing calm for summer. Swooshy hair, pointy ears. Oh, his ears are getting bigger and bigger. There we go, he's looking pretty calm there, isn't he? Oh, we've got some different ones now. Let's see, we've got excited and scared. And we've got exhausted. Oh, I did excited, didn't I? So let's try exhausted. I don't think I've ever drawn any of these characters looking sleepy. Let's give that a go. So we do the big U, the swooshy hair, pointy ears, let's try an make his eyes half closed. Oh, looking a bit more like a grumpy sort of exhausted, isn't he? We've all felt a bit grumpy and exhausted, haven't we? Let's give him some bags under his eyes. He's so tired. Oh, he looks all sorts of feelings there, doesn't he? Okay, should we try one more? And we have, let's see, what have we got? Let's, we tried frightened. I'm just wondering if I can do that looking a bit different now. Frightened. Okay. I think I'm going to just make it look a bit like anxious, aren't I? Intimidated. Whoa, these are some big words here. Okay. Intimidated and frightened. They're kind of similar. So let's give that.
That's a nice one, Jo. Shy.
Shy. Oh, thank you. Shy. Okay. I think for shy, I think we show a lot more of how we feel shy in our body language. But let's see if we can also show it on our face. So it's the pointy ears. I'm going to move his eyes down a bit. So maybe it's like he's looking. Okay, maybe looking a little bit unsure, isn't he? We got jealous on the list as well. Okay, shy and jealous. Jealous. Oh God, this is really challenging. Okay, jealous. Swooshy hair. Pointy ears. It's going to be all about the eyebrows. I think we're going to give a bit of a side eye look to someone. Okay. I think he's jealous of someone's looking, someone over here. He's a little jealous of me in this picture, isn't he? Because he's looking towards me. Okay, that's great, everyone. Thank you so much. If there's any more, that's great. Otherwise, we might do some questions. Oh, hello, Emily.
Hello. Shall we move on to some questions?
Sounds good. Hello. Just change Summer because I don't like him looking so grumpy beside me.
And staring at you.
Yeah.
So teachers, you can ask Jo anything. You might want to ask her about the characters. You might want to ask her about the books. Put your questions in the chat and we will read them out.
We've got, what is your favourite page? I do have a favourite page in Hello Summer, and the clue is with what I'm wearing. It's my favourite flower, and it's pretty much the first page. It's this page here. I just love all the sunflowers on that page, and it makes me feel happy, because that flower always makes me feel happy.
Great question. What is your favourite season?
Oh, my favourite season. I think it's a tie between summer and winter because I like being out in the sun and having a nice time with friends, but I also do like a bit of icy cold days. So I like the extremities. I like big summer, big winter.
Interesting. We've got lots of great questions. What made you write the book?
Well, the stories are all about feelings, and as you know, as we've been talking, and it kind of was inspired by my niece having a few problems with her big feelings when she was very little. And so I started thinking about, you know, how it feels to go through life that way. And these stories are largely inspired by the things that her and her family do to make her feel better.
Oh, so really the book is empathy.
The book is empathy. Yes, exactly.
How did you make the book? That's a great question.
That is a good question. And I do have some things to hand to help explain how I make the book. So there's lots of stages, and Emily is a big part of those stages because she helps me write it. And she has other people that work with her that help me draw it. But they help, like your teachers might help you. They don't hold your hand and do it for you. They just help advise you and they just make everything better. So thank you, Emily. And so the sketchbook here will show you how they started. So they didn't start looking out how we know them today. These are really early sketches, just exploring how each season might look. And then I started to think about what they might be wearing. And then started thinking about how the pages might work. And it just develops, and it starts to get clearer and clearer. So we started to see here how winter is looking. And she looks a lot more similar now to how she is on these later pages of the sketchbook. And then we start thinking about her clothes and her colorings. And so that's the early stage development. And what I have here is some sketches. These are sketches of Hello Winter, but I'll flash them up on the screen so it doesn't give away the story. But this is how we start. Start with really basic sketches of how it's gonna, each page is going to be. And then when I'm ready, I move on to the iPad and I draw it all up on the iPad, and it's then printed to look like these. That's the process.
That's fascinating, Jo. Related question, why did you want to be an author?
Ooh. Well, I started off more doing just the illustration side of things. So illustrators draw the pictures and authors write the stories. And I started drawing some characters, such as the ones I just showed you, but they didn't have stories behind them. And so I decided I wanted to tell my own stories as well as draw other people's. I really like drawing other people's stories as well, but I did have some bottled up somewhere up in here that I wanted to tell. So that's why.
Lovely next question. What was your favourite book when you were growing up?
Oh, favourites. I struggle with favourites because there are so many wonderful things out there. It's really hard to pick one.
We'll let Jo have several, right?
Because I still have them. Can you believe it? So I've got some here. So, okay, it's not really a picture book as such because there are some pictures in it, but I just wanted this story read to me all the time. And it's The Velveteen Rabbit. And I just love this story so, so much. In fact, I haven't read it in so many years that I feel like I might read it tonight. So that's what was my favorite story when I was growing up. But I also really liked funny stuff. So this kind of stuff, a bit of Roald Dahl and Quentin Blake. These stories are, I find, quite funny. So those were a couple of my favorites when I was little.
Really interesting next question. We would like to know, what is your favorite thing about books?
I think still for me, my favorite thing about, well, picture books in the main would be probably the characters, the character designs. I can't get enough of them. So I have loads and loads of picture books just so I can enjoy how other people draw characters. So we got here Jeremy worried about the wind. And I just love how these little extra characters have so much personality. And those kind of books. And then I also like these kind as well. So one of my favorite things about this book are these two quite naughty cavemen. I think they just look brilliant. So yeah, for me, my favorite thing about picture books is the characters.
Great answer. These are great questions, by the way, everyone. Several classes have asked, which is your favourite book that you've written?
Ooh, that's a tough one. We don't know, but I think it's got to be this one at the moment, Hello Summer. I think it's a fun story, and I really, as you know, it's my favorite, one of my favorite seasons, so I think it's one that'll be why it's one of my favorites. But ask me again in November when Hello Winter comes out, and you never know, it might be a different favorite.
And big question, do you enjoy making books?
Yeah, nearly every day I do. Sometimes like everything you do, sometimes it's, you have maybe an off day, you just have to walk away from it and come back to it. And maybe everyone else feels the same when they're drawing or they're writing. Sometimes it just doesn't feel like it's going right, and you get really frustrated or you get really angry, and the best thing to do is just to give it a bit of a break and then come back to it and you'll love it again. So that's how I feel, that's what happens to me.
Yeah, very true. Practical question, how long did it take to make the book?
Oh, it feels really hard to remember. Like, I feel like sometimes, oh, it was 3 months, but no, it was probably more like 5 months or something like that. It was a long time from start to finish, because first of all, we write the story, and that takes time in itself. We have to sort of make every word special, and then the drawing process, as you saw, was quite long. We start with the sketches and then develop onto the final pieces. So I don't know. 4 months? Let's say 4 months. A long time.
And Jo's books have a lot of detail. All yeah. Those flowers.
Talking of detail, this is the one with the detail. Drew every leaf in this one. There are so many leaves. Autumn is a very leafy season.
Who is your favorite character?
Who's my favorite character?
Is that of Jo's own characters, or is that out of all of books? Maybe answer both if you can.
Okay, favorite character. Now, having said summer and winter are my favorite seasons, I think of my books, autumn is my favorite character. I there's something about him, he just looks very cuddleable, and I think that's just a nice quality about him. So I would say autumn of these books here would be my favorite character. And then my favorite character of all time, how do we answer that? I don't think I can't pick one. My brain's gone blank, completely blank. I think one of my favorite characters in literature and film would be Matilda, actually, thinking about it now. I just always, as soon as I read it and then watched it, it was just immediately like, there's something about her that's really special. And I like her character.
And she loves books.
And so. She loves books, exactly.
Any more questions? I'm just going to scroll up quickly and see. Oh, I did miss a question. Are you planning on bringing out any more books?
Yes. So we have Hello Winter coming out. So let's find the cover for that. So let's get that nice and close so you can see. So Hello Winter story will be out in November. And then I also illustrate books for older readers. And so those are the sort that have got black and white drawings in. So this is one of them, and show you some more silly characters than that one. That's a squid. So this one's just come out, but there's another one coming out as well. But I've got some new book ideas as well that I'm working on a little bit in the back of my brain, working through some ideas. And I think what I'd really like is to do books with animals in them. I've done a lot of people books. I really want to do some funny animals now.
Can I ask a question? What's your favourite animal?
What's my favourite animal? I think elephants. I love an elephant. I was really lucky and saw some when I was quite a bit younger. And ever since then, just been my favourites. They're quite cute and playful, even though they're so big. I like that.
Good answer. I imagine there are a lot of elephant fans in the room. We've just got 1 minute to go. So let's throw in one final question. When did you start making books, Jo?
I started making books in 2019. So what's that? 4 years ago. Before that, I was actually an architect, and that's someone that draws and designs buildings. But I much preferred drawing silly things. So that's why I switched. So the first book that came out was Excitable Edgar. And I don't know if any of you would remember the advert at Christmas time with this dragon, but that was quite a while ago now. So maybe we don't remember. But yeah, that was my first book.
Interesting. I think we do have time for just one more question. Does anyone want to ask Jo a final question? Suspense. I'm just going to scroll up and see if I've missed anything. Maybe we've asked you all. I have a very final question, okay. And it's a very personal one. Do you have a favorite emotion?
Well, that's an interesting question. Favorite emotion. I quite like it when I feel relieved. You know, when you've been really worried about something and it all comes better and you get that amazing rush of happy feeling through your veins and you're just relieved. So yeah, I like that. I mean, I probably should say happy and excited and all those kind of things, but yeah, I quite like feeling relieved.
That's a very good feeling. Jo, thank you so much. It's been lovely to hear all your answers to those awesome questions. Thank you, everyone.
Oh, thank you, everyone. Yeah, it's been brilliant.